Check out Rhinozilla. He's up on your shoulder like he's the king of the garden.
Royal Rhino. He wouldn't be king of the garden, though. He'd be part of the animal kingdom.
Rhino doesn't care what kingdom he's part of, as long as he's king. Right, Rhino?
Rhino may not care, but scientists do. They use the five kingdoms to help understand the similarities and differences among living things.
Wait, five kingdoms?
Yeah. Animal, plant, protist, fungi, and bacteria.
Well, I knew Rhino belonged to the animal kingdom.
True. Do you know why?
Because he's an animal?
Of course he is. To actually be part of the animal kingdom, you've got to fit the profile. An animal is any living creature that can breathe and move about. They don't make their own food, and they have many cells.
Must be a pretty big kingdom, then. There are tons of creatures just in this garden that fit that profile. That bird, that bunny hiding in the brush, even that butterfly.
The animal kingdom is pretty big, but so is the plant kingdom. Just look around the garden.
I know. Roses, daisies, all the trees, the grass.
Yep. A plant is any organism that has a green pigment called chlorophyll. They use it to make food from the sun's energy.
Photosynthesis.
Exactly. Plants have multiple cells, too, like animals, but can't move around.
Good thing they don't. That'd make picking flowers pretty difficult. Now, what about fungi? That's mushrooms, right? I thought fungi were types of plants.
Mushrooms are fungi, yeah. But fungi are a lot different from plants. They don't have roots, flowers, or leaves. They don't have chlorophyll either. No photosynthesis for them. They eat decaying matter instead.
Gross.
Gross, but helpful. Mildew and mold are fungi too, like the mold on that fruit right there. By eating decaying matter, fungi break things down so that the nutrients can be recycled into the soil.
Oh, cool.
Now wait until you hear about protists.
Yeah, what kind of things are protists?
Lots of things. Algae, amoebas, protozoans. Protists are pretty neat. They're teeny tiny single-celled organisms that live together in colonies. They can move around like animals, but most can also make their own food.
Wow, sounds like the best of both kingdoms. Are there protists in the garden?
Sure, but most protists can only be seen with the microscope, so you can't see them. But they're there.
I bet the last kingdom is there too. Bacteria. Yuck!
Oh yeah. Bacteria are everywhere, even inside you. They're super tiny and only have one cell, but they can live in extreme conditions, like in your stomach.
What? Don't bacteria make you sick?
Bacteria can cause disease, but some of the ones in your stomach actually help break down your food.
Kind of like fungi?
Yes. Actually, bacteria and fungi sometimes work together to break down things in nature.
It really is pretty sweet how all living organisms can be classified into one of five kingdoms. Whether something is an animal, plant, fungus, protist, or bacteria, scientists have a kingdom for it. By grouping organisms into those five kingdoms, scientists can understand the similarities and differences among living things. Well, now I know about all five kingdoms. Just call me the King of the Kingdoms.
I think I'll just stick to RJ.